left aside. Again, it's Chara. And Chara able to shake free this time. Outlet pass is on now for the control of Horton. Gave it back up to Lucic, and a shot is blocked aside, and down on the ice now is Horton.
This one's a whole lot of nasty. Aaron Rome comes up and just delivers a crushing open ice hit.
Well, Nathan Horton is in some serious trouble right now.
Right after he distributed the puck to Milan Lucic, Rome stepped up and planted him.
Nathan Horton lets go of the pass, and that is a late hit by Aaron Rome after Nathan Horton had distributed that puck to Milan Lucic.
Eddie, that's Rule 48 personified, the blindside hit to a vulnerable player with contact to the head with the left shoulder. Slow motion doesn't do justice because he is going at a high rate of speed when Rome explodes into him.
Yeah, he let go of that puck. And no chance for Nathan Horton to be able to protect himself. I mean, that is a danger area as far as the ice. Coming through the middle at real speed, Nathan Horton passes his puck. Could be a 5-minute interference call.
He's going off the ice. He's going away. He's done.
Notice.
He gets a 5-minute major and a game misconduct. I just talked to one of the officials, so that's why he was leaving the penalty box and going to the Vancouver Canuck dressing room.
A restless quiet here as they tend to Nathan Horton. The hero-villain relationship we talked about has just been intensified by three. This time there is at least some justice in a penalty, a major. But there are greater concerns right now.
You're coming through the middle of the ice. Once you distribute that puck, there's a second or two that lapses. More times than not, you're bracing for that collision. But I don't think Nathan Horton ever anticipated that Aaron Rome would come from the wing, from the weak side. There's Horton. It's a 2-on-2. He moves the puck, and he never anticipates Aaron Rome to step up. Now, if he has the puck on his stick on that particular play, but he lets it go, and he steps up and hits him absolutely way too late.
And, Eddie, that's why the league put in Rule 48, is it not? To protect players that are vulnerable like Nathan Horton in that situation.
And I think sometimes, Pierre, is that you have to take responsibility if you are the puck carrier, and after you move the puck and distribute, you're going straight up the ice. You have to recognize where the players are on the ice who might come and try to impede your progress. I mean, Pierre, I don't know if that is a blindside hit when the player is standing right in front of Nathan Horton. He did not track him from the blind spot. Nathan Horton was skating straight up the ice. He was not looking straight ahead. He was looking off to the side with Aaron Rome standing in front of him. And I don't know if that's a blindside hit with him standing right in front or moving in front of Nathan Horton.
One of those close-ups, we noticed eyes moving and some conversation coming from Horton. We look for any good signs we can get right now.
Mikey.
This was just moments ago. The lifting of Nathan Horton onto the stretcher. The restraints had been applied all around his neck area and head so that there couldn't be any sort of interference, as you had indicated, Eddie, is exactly the call. Interference major in a game misconduct. Again, we will only report that we did see him in conversation. He was saying things. His eyes were moving normally. That's what we saw just before they lifted him up. Okay. Here comes.